Number 75. Pressure in the spinal fluid is measured as shown in figure 11.42. If the pressure in the spinal fluid is 10 millimeters of mercury, letter A, what is the reading of the water manometer in centimeters of water? All right, so basically, we have to convert, right? For letter A here, it's basically asking us to convert 10 millimeters of mercury into centimeters of water. So what I'm going to do is they're telling me heights, essentially, right? They're telling me that it's 10 millimeters of mercury, and we got to convert from mercury now into a height of water. So I'm going to use this formula down here on the bottom right. I'm going to realize that the pressure given in terms of mercury will be equal to the pressure given in terms of water. Okay, so now I'm going to expand on each of these, and I'm going to realize that this is the height of the mercury multiplied by the density of the mercury. Okay, multiplied by the density of the mercury, multiplied then by gravity, will equal then the height of the water multiplied by the density of the water, okay? Times gravity, that is. Now remember that, you know, mathematically speaking, these gravities can just cancel. So now what I'm left with is I'm left with, you know, the simplified height of the mercury times the density of the mercury equals the height of the water times the density of the water. But they do want us to find out what is the reading of the water manometer in centimeters, right, of water, basically. So they want us to calculate the height of the water, essentially. So solving this equation for the height of the water, just divide out the density of the water from both sides. So what that'll give us now is that'll give us the height of the water will equal then the height of the mercury multiplied by the density of the mercury divided then by the density of the water. Now, if you notice, if these two densities are of the same unit, which they should be, right, kilogram per cubic meter would be recommended, or you can do, I mean, gram per milliliter, it doesn't really matter, as long as they're the same, you can really plug in whatever unit of height here for mercury you want. Not whatever value, but whatever unit you want. So they told us it's 10 millimeters. What I could do is I can then take 10 millimeters and say, well, what is that in centimeters of mercury? I mean, it's just converting millimeters to centimeters. And then plug that in here. And if I plug centimeters in here, I'm going to get my answer out in centimeters of water. Okay? So watch. So we have the height of the water will be equal to the height of the mercury in centimeters because I want the height of the water in centimeters. So I have to be, you know, consistent here. So 10 millimeters is equivalent to how many centimeters? Well, you divide that by 10, essentially, right? 10 millimeters is equal to 1 centimeter. Okay, great. Then multiply that by the density of mercury. Doesn't matter which unit you use. Just make sure you're consistent. I'm going to use the value of kilogram per cubic meter. And then I'm going to divide that by the density of the water in kilogram per cubic meter. That's also 1,000. So notice this is all we need to do, right? 1 times 13,600 divided by 1,000, right? We don't even need a calculator for this, although I'm plugging it anyway. Comes out to be 13.6 centimeters now, right? This is the answer. And we can just write of water. Why of water? Because that's the height that we're talking about, right? Height of the water. So we just kind of add this little term in at the end. All right, so that would be the answer for letter A. And looking at this and trying to figure out for letter B, let's see what it says. It says, what is the reading if the person sits up, placing the top of the fluid 60 centimeters above the tap? So base, and the fluid density is 1.05 gram per milliliter. So basically, we know in terms of the nature of this picture, right, for letter A, maybe I should have said this before, but here's where they're doing their little spinal tap, right? And here's where the column of water is. And we're basically assuming that they're at the same height. Okay, so that's why I didn't have to take into account the vertical height of this person. But now this person's going to stand up, okay? And when they stand up, this tap is going to be in the same place, right? But the distribution of the fluid will not be at the same height anymore, right? If you think about rotating, right? Here's essentially the axis of the fluid. And now what we're going to look to do is rotate the person on up. So what's going to happen when they get rotated up now? Well, there's going to be an additional pressure, because there's an additional force due to gravity acting on this point, right? Gravity was pulling the fluid down here, right, in the spinal column. And gravity's still pulling the fluid down now when the person's up vertically, but it's now pushing down directly on this spinal tap. So we have to add the additional pressure, okay, of this height of fluid, all right? So basically, I can come up with this formula, right? I can say that Now the, I'll just call it the new pressure when the person is upright, will equal the pressure when the person was lying down, plus now the additional amount of pressure from standing up, let's just say. All right? So the new pressure is equal to the pressure of them laying down, plus then the additional pressure of now them standing up and the pressure due to gravity now, essentially, of that fluid. Okay? All right. Hopefully that makes sense. Now we're going to continue forward. So the new pressure will be equal to the pressure laying down. That's what we just found over here, right? 13.6. So I'm just going to leave that alone. We can plug that in when we need. Plus now the pressure when they're standing up. But when they're standing up, remember, now they have a certain height to this spinal fluid. And they also told us the density of the spinal fluid. So that has a certain G rho value. And then we probably multiply it by G, right? Because we're basically trying to find the weight of it. So here is the formula, right, that I'm essentially using over on the right-hand side. So I can now substitute out the variable, right, pressure of standing up to now mean it's the height of the spinal fluid multiplied by the density of the spinal fluid multiplied by gravity. And now I should have everything I need to plug in, all right? So just make sure that all the units are consistent here. That's the biggest thing. So let me think now. So what might be best, I'm just thinking about, okay, so what might be best here is if we're probably going to have to convert this somehow, all right, because this is going to be, if I plug in the values exactly how I'm giving them to you, right, this is going to be in terms of height of spinal fluid, but we need it in terms of the height of water overall, right? We need to have them consistent. So let me do this. Let me take this. All right, and do a quick conversion on it. Remember, the reason why I'm doing this is because we need consistent units, okay? So similarly, just like how I did my conversion essentially over here, I'm going to do the same thing now, converting from the spinal fluid heights into water heights, okay? So let me do this over here on the side. So the height of the spinal fluid multiplied by the density of the spinal fluid will equal the height of the water that's read in the manometer, multiplied then by the density of the water. Why did I leave out gravity? Because they would both cancel, right, in both terms. So that's why I left it out. Let's calculate now for height of the water, just like I did over here. I'm basically doing the same thing. So the height of the water will be equal to the height of the spinal fluid multiplied by the density of that spinal fluid all over the density of water. And now we can just plug in, right? So the height of the water will equal the height of the spinal fluid. I want that in terms of centimeters because, again, I'm using the unit centimeters of water over here. So I need the same units. Fortunately, they gave me the height, right, of the spinal fluid in centimeters. So I can just plug in the 60, okay? Just plug in the value of 60 there. Times in the density of the spinal fluid. Now, they gave it to us in grams per milliliter. You can leave it in those units. That's fine. You can convert that into kilogram per cubic meter. I don't have a problem with that. Whichever way you want to do it. But whatever you do, you better be consistent with the units of your density at the bottom. Okay? Otherwise, the units won't cancel properly. What I'm going to do is I'm going to plug in the 1.05 value, the grams per milliliter. And then when I plug in now my density of water, I better use gram per milliliter. So that's just 1, right? 1.00. So I'm just going to round to 1. Well, not round. I'm just going to cut off the significant figures. So now I realize that here is the height of the water, okay? And now what I can do is basically just plug it all on into my equation here, all right? So the new pressure, right, in terms of height of water, will equal the pressure of the fluid lying down in terms of the height of water, which I had is 13.6, right, centimeters of H2O. Then plus now, right, this new value, okay, of 60 times 1.05. So let's do that now. So 60 times 1.05, it's about 63. So plus now 63.0 centimeters of water, okay? And so technically speaking, right in here, right, I really should substitute this on out, okay, just to be totally clear. What I need to plug in here is going to be the pressure. This is correct, right, the pressure that's now being exhibited by the person standing up, but in terms of the value, I need it in terms of water here, all right? So now I'll just write this. So the height of the spinal fluid multiplied by the density of the spinal fluid all over the density of the water. I'm just copying this on in. And now all we have to do is a simple addition, right? So the new height now will be just the addition of those two. We have the same units, so this is why we did the conversion that way. So this is going to be 76.6 centimeters of water, okay? And that's going to be the new pressure with them standing up. Now you can convert it to whatever units you want. Meters of water, millimeters, it doesn't matter. You can convert it to Pascal. You can do whatever you like. So convert it however you want. These are answers. If you want to convert it into a different unit, by all means, go for it. Thank you guys for tuning in. Appreciate it very much. Please remember to subscribe. We'll see you next time.